Hey guys, it's your girl Naturally Nata here, and I'm back with another video. So today I'm going to be doing a natural hair transformation for you guys. I'm going to show you how I take my hair from this, which is curly and freshly washed, to this, which is nice and blown out and big. I'm going to be doing a tension method blowout for you guys, and then I'm going to show you how I take my hair to this, which is my first time straightening my hair since 2016 with an actual flat iron. So I'm going to show you how I do it. I'm going to be using this DUVOLLE Impulse Far Infrared hair straightener, a $200 hair straightener, and these are my results, which I absolutely loved, and we'll talk about if I think it's worth it. But if you're interested in seeing me do this hair transformation, you know what to do. Just please stay tuned. Just want a cozy little Christmas here with you. So Mr. Santa. Alright guys, so as you can see, I am starting out on freshly washed hair. I have it sectioned off into 4 sections. I'm just twisting up the bottom last section right there, and I am just preparing myself for what we're about to do because it's going to take quite a while. So I'm using this Madam CJ Walker silkening leave-in. This brand is actually still available. They're usually sold at Sephora. It is a more of a high-end natural hair brand, but these specific products that I'm using are not, so I'm really sorry about that. But I wanted to use these because, like I said, they are very expensive, and I did do a review on this brand quite a while ago when they first came out, but I hardly get to use them because I hardly ever straighten my hair, so I wanted to pull them on out. But use some type of leave-in, and then I'm going to use a heat protectant, which is this Beyond the Zone Turn Up the Heat. A heat protectant is extremely important because you want to protect your hair from any heat damage as much as possible, and this is just going to add some nice sheen and moisturization to your hair. And you'll be able to see right here on my strands how much oil it added to my hair, and that's going to protect it from heat damage. So now I'm going to take a blow dryer, and I'm going to just pull my hair straight down, and that is the tension method of blow drying your hair. So I don't have the heat up too high on its highest setting. I have it on the medium setting, and I'm just pulling my hair tight, creating that tension, and I'm running the blow dryer up and down the shaft of my hair. Then I'm going to go in with my Demon brush once my hair is pretty dry and straight, and I'm going to run that through my hair while I blow dry it. This was my first time actually doing the tension method as far as blowing out my hair. Usually when I blow out my hair, I just use a blow dryer that already has a comb on it, but I can say that I like this better because your hair tends to get kind of ripped out sometimes when you use a blow dryer with a comb, and I feel like with this I lost less hair, so that is always a good thing. And as you can see, it works very, very well. And quite surprisingly to me, it did blow dry my hair very quickly. My hair dried quickly. I thought it would take longer to blow dry my hair since I wasn't using the comb, and I feel like the heat is closer to your hair when you have the comb attachment to a blow dryer. But I can say this worked very, very well and very quickly, and I feel like I ripped out less of my hair. So it was a win-win situation. These are my results just for that little front section. As you can see, it does elongate your hair, and my hair is completely dry. So we're just going to, you know, keep on going, and we're going to continue with this process until our hair is completely blow dried. So the other product that I used to prep my hair for blow drying was this Madam CJ Walker Silkening Blowout Cream. So as you can see, my hair was in 4 large sections. On each large section, I would go in with that silkening blowout cream. And then on the smaller sections that I was blow drying, I would use the Beyond the Zone Turn Up the Heat on each small section that I went to blow dry right before I blow dried it. So I did use that on all 4 sections, and my hair is now completely blow dried. so much growth that my hair has experienced since I've been wearing wigs and protective styles. I attribute all the growth of my natural hair to doing that, braiding my hair down and just leaving it alone a lot. If you have been a long time subscriber of mine, you know that I did have some struggles with my natural hair. I started out YouTube with extremely long hair, longer than this, and then I had my hair bleached blonde and then dyed purple, which completely ruined it. But now my hair is back, and I definitely do attribute it to doing protective styles and wearing wigs. So now I'm going to be showing you this DUVOLLE Impulse Infrared Technology Professional Flat Iron. As you can see, it is a professional flat iron. It has tourmaline ceramic plates. It has a high performance heating element for even heat, negative ion technology, which gives hair more shine and less frizz. It instantly heats. And it has variable temperature settings, which you're going to see right here. As you can see, it starts in the higher 200s, about 250, 270. And then you can just hit the on button over and over and over to take the temperature up all the way to 450. I am going to be using this flat iron on 450 today. So I'm starting off with a small section of hair in the back of my hair, the back of my head. And I'm going to do two passes with this flat iron on 450. I'm starting out with the first pass at the root of my hair, and I'm just going to take it slowly down to the ends. And now I'm going in with the second pass, and I'm also using a rat tail comb coupled with the flat iron, dragging them both down the length of my hair, and that's going to get that maximum straightness. And as you can see, we have some pretty good results. So as you can see, I do have the entire back section of my hair flat ironed, and I do like how it's looking. You can see at the root, it's very, very straight. So I'm going to go ahead and move on to the next section of hair and just repeat these steps, section it off into a small section. So the smaller, the better, really. And I'm going to go ahead and do two passes with the flat iron. The second pass, use my rat tail comb to chase, quote unquote, the flat iron, and that's going to give us the maximum straightness. And I'm just going to do it over and over until my hair is completely straight. Okay guys, so I am finally done, and these are my results. As you can see, this flat iron did not get my hair completely bone straight, but I am not mad about it. I actually like the results, and I feel like my hair did not get fried or pulled out using this flat iron. For it being my first time using a flat iron in almost 4 years, I am very happy with these results, and I feel like it was a healthy way to go using this flat iron. And you can get this flat iron for 70% off using my code Renata70, which does take this flat iron from $195 all the way down to a little bit less than $60. So with for it being a $60 flat iron, I am very happy with the results. But we definitely need to go in and clip these ends because they are looking a hot ASS mess. So I am going to take some scissors and I am going to clip each side of my hair. I parted my hair right down the middle, put the hair on either side of my head on the, you know, where my ears are at. And I put a hair tie at the very end of my hair where I wanted to cut it. And I just went ahead and just took the plunge and snipped it off. And as you can see, I have a nice straight line. Some of the hair in the very front towards the very, you know, right where my scalp is at, my forehead is, it's a bit longer. It did not clip it all the way straight. So I'm taking my scissors and I'm just going to clip that excess hair off. And then I'm going to take the hair that is closest to my forehead, right in the middle of my forehead, and I'm going to pull it diagonally to the side, and I'm just going to clip that too, just to make sure that everything is nice and straight, and it creates a little bit of a layer right there in the front. And then I'm just going to repeat those steps on the other side, and these are my final results after blow drying and flat ironing and then trimming my hair. This is my natural hair transformation from curly to straight. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. I am so happy with these results, and my hair lasted for over 2 weeks and it just got straighter as time went on. So I really, really liked it. I really had a great experience with flat ironing my hair. For it being so long that I've actually done so, and I really feel like it was a healthy way to do it, and I feel like this flat iron was a healthy tool to use to flat iron my hair. So I really like it, and I cannot wait to continue to use this flat iron on wigs and, you know, when I decide to straighten my hair again. You do not have to be afraid to straighten your hair if you use healthy tools and if you do not do it so often. So I was not afraid to do this. I was actually pretty excited to do it because it's been so long. I really hope you guys enjoyed this once again. Please check the description box below for these products, and I cannot wait to hopefully see you in my next video. Bye-bye.